Everybody, and now welcome to the Right Talk series. And we always try to make sure that we try to teach something and people are able to achieve the financial freedom. And today, being the topic itself, having a financial freedom is makes me to think quite a lot that we how we can make sure the people are financially free in their mind. So actually, financial freedom have a very different notion, the definitions and thoughts. I will prefer all of you to let me know what is your thought. To give a brief, I am Rachna Regu. I am a director of Right Horizons. I have around 26 years of experience, being not in a, I can say financial term more. I was worked in IT, Infosys and Wipro for almost 15, 16 years. And then I thought I should have a quotes unquote financial freedom. And I got it and I joined Right Horizons. So that's what I am all about. And that the series also talks the same thing. So most of the time, any of my webinars or any of my talks has 100% sure of that what I have applied and what I have learned from my customer and myself, that only I try to say because I know that that works or not works. So that's the same thing. So when we felt ourselves has been having a financial freedom, why don't we express to others, and then we will also learn over the period. Financial freedom, as I told you, everybody have the different thoughts. So if anybody can just share their thoughts, what comes in their mind, this is meetings. You can unmute and speak with us. And if you want, you can write it on the chat. It will be great because I feel we can have the more both as a conversation than a one just side talk. Anybody wants to share their thoughts on what they...
Yeah.
Please.
Hello, ma'am. So I can go. Basically, to me, financial freedom means is that, you know, my money is making money for myself.
Yeah.
And I don't have to trade my time to make money, to be honest. And I believe this is really important because as we age, our skills kind of diminish, so it becomes outdated and becomes difficult for us to continue to grow at the same pace what we are used to. And secondly, as we age, we also have sufficient money corpus and we should put that to use to earn more money. So that is what my term is, financial freedom.
Very much true. And one of my topic is also on how to create the alternative channel of income. And that's what you are so speaking about, that how money makes money. And it's such a nice phrase by itself, that money. So it's like so many times when we keep reading the different book, it says that so money is creating or generating when you're sleeping. How to do that? So that's one of the thoughts. Anybody else wanted to share it? Actually, I am not able to see the people. If you can tell me your name, it will be also the great.
Hello.
Yeah, please.
Hello.
Yes.
Myself, Radha, ma'am.
Yes.
Okay. I have just joined the.
Thank you. So what do you think about the financial freedom, Radha?
Financial freedom, I am already working, ma'am.
Yes.
But not able to take the decisions in the financial issues.
Okay.
Because when I have to plan to buy a home, it's not possible. Okay. And, confusion about the finance only.
Okay, so that's nice. I got the 3 points from there. Is one is how to take a decision on a financial aspect. Second is how to be clear, not to have confusion when you're deciding. And third is one of your goal, like how you said it approximately is in your side is like a house or a maybe assets or something. Make sure that you are going into the right direction. And this is make me to give you the live example, which I have worked last 1 week itself. And it is a very, very it's similar one like her or something, because the person who came to me, normally I take only through reference from customers. So one of her reference has come to me and he says, ma'am, why don't you speak to this person? And she wants to, she's also joined one of your webinar and she wants to speak with you only. Okay, fair enough. And And the person is, when I was speaking with her, I think it's last Sunday. So spoke and I said, why don't you tell something about yourself? So she says, actually, I'm a CA with 25 years experience and working as a finance head for the last 25 years in one of the very reputed company. Then I was laughing and she said, why? I said, why? Because you are a CA, I'm not even CA. And you 25 years experience and you have been doing so well in one of the companies, which is a very reputed one. Why you need a financial planning? You must have done financial planning yourself. And it's a very good salary also she is getting. And not only her, her kids, are both of them are also CA. So I was telling to her, actually, you have come to the wrong place. I think so I should come to your place, not you have to come and ask me. So she said, no, Rashna, it's always good to have a second opinion to find it out. Is it I'm doing right or wrong? So I said, fine, fair enough. Why don't you give the details? And to my surprise, this is my last week learning, is the person who is financially so aware of doing the she is in a software company, but in a financial department, in and out of a financial product, 25 years experience, earning so good, but her last line was, Rachna, my month on month is just hand to mouth. Made me to think so much, and that was one of the reason I felt it. I will use, instead of financial planning, the word freedom, because the freedom comes with your flexibility, your mind, your decision power, as you say, and remove your conclusions and confusions. So conclusion comes very easily when you are free in your mind. And the reason there's a lot of difference between financial planning and financial freedom. So I asked her actually what exactly happened. And it's not that she doesn't have a good net worth. She has an amazing net worth. But when I saw the net worth is something which we don't realize it, that she had a real estate 96%, means 4 plots, 2 houses, 1 staying, 3 of them EMIs are going on. And because her husband is having a business, and last 10 months or 11 months, there is no income from the husband's side. And her EMI, she is not able to pay with a single income. And she says, now what to do? Because it is creating a lot of issue, and selling a real estate is not so easy to do it immediately, because she doesn't want it. And I said, you should not do distress sell. But she doesn't have any flexibility of money to even, I told her, if you give me a 1 lakh, do you think you can give me 1 lakh? No liquid assets. Sometimes this is the one of the major learning I wanted to share in this, because I learned this. Sometimes I start perceiving notion that, yes, I am a part of a finance. I am been doing so good. And my alternative income will take care, because she says my rentals will take care. Coincidentally, last 3-4 months, she doesn't have her rents coming across, because she has net off the rent with the EMI. Now rent is not coming, so EMI is trying to do issues. So she is one of the places she is even default. So these are the things which I like to share most of the time, and this is my learning. Please make sure all of you, whoever is there, in your any portfolio, portfolio indirectly, I'm trying to say it's not only the liquid asset portfolio, you're taking care of your fixed assets, your real estates, your car, whatever I can say, you should never go fixed more than... See, like some person, she told me, Rachna, I have a PF. Now, PF money, I cannot withdraw. I have an insurance. Insurance is a traditional insurance. I cannot withdraw. So some of the times we have been doing a very good investments, but we are not able to withdraw when we require. So that's another thing I always believe that have a very clear cut how we can make sure that you are taking care of. So I'll just go ahead and take care now. So Nidisha, make everybody mute now.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, before you go, there is a person named Rajesh. So he just wants to tell you, can you also please cover aspects of different types of financial investment and how much should be the split? Also, what should be the retiring kitty one should plan? Yeah. On a times
so
of your current
investment option is part of that, but asset allocation is not part of that. I think so. I'll be taking either within 2-3 weeks the asset allocation as a session, or he can write it to me. I can help him out to tell me about asset allocation. But all the investment option is a part of this seminar. Okay. So what comes in your mind, the freedom? So I was having a kid of one teenager's going and one teenager coming, he's 19 and 14. And when I speak with them, so indirectly, it's a different aspect. What means a freedom? So I was telling my daughter why you wanted to go abroad and study. You can study here only. So she says, no, mama, it's a very nice thinking when you stay alone, you be independent and try to study in the separate place. You learn quite a lot, and even which I agree every time. But in their mind, the freedom comes when you don't have a boundaries. So everybody have a different things on a freedom, how you make a freedom in your mind. For me, it is freedom starts and ends in my mind. What do you mean by financial freedom is, if something happens to me the next moment, my all financial goals of my kids and my family is being achieved. That is my mind call in my definition of financial freedom. So I am ready for all the, because the worst come worst is only that we can think of as the death. So if something happens to me, my family is secured, my family's all goals are achieved, and I have no obligation which I'm passing on to the next level. And this reminds me, there's another story. I go for a Christ College for the wealth management as a session, which is 40 hours session. They have a 2 points credit, so I go there. And one of the student called me long back, maybe I can say 1 year back, and she called me and she said, Rachna, ma'am, can you help me? And I said, yeah, please tell me how I can help you. So she says, no, my dad expired and my mom is housewife and I don't know how to help, because she was in second year at that time. So I said, okay, let me try helping how I can do. So she says, so most of these time when the people come to me for a solution, I also feel sometimes bad because I don't have a ready-made solution than anything else. Then helping them to get at least a job or help people to get the job from my network or something like that. So I said, okay, just give it to me on mom's number. I'll try to speak. So when I was speaking with their mom, and she told me that I was not even aware that where all he has taken the loans and how he was managing. So now after his death, I realize it. He has taken so much of loan, and he has not even taken any insurance against the loan or higher term cover kind of it. So more than surviving, I don't know how to repay the loans. And that repaying the loan is not home loans. It is his business loans, which is 1 crore. And it is too high. And that is another level I always believe that it is okay. So many times I've been doing, of course, the trends are changing now. There's a lot of women investors are coming. But sometimes before people used to say that, no, Rachna, my husband or my dad or somebody else take the decision. And this is the one thing I always tell, it is good if they are doing wonderfully good, there's nothing wrong. But be aware. Be aware of what is happening. And there are so many stories, because I do a financial transit quite a lot of places. And people who are master level educated, but they have never spoken about debts or something. So this picture talks millions, which we try to say, what is a financial freedom is like how to reduce expenses. So it's a daily cash flows we have to take care. We have to simplify life. Most of the customers come and tell me, Rachna, I didn't understand this product, or I didn't understand this how to do. First level, I'll try to explain them. And if they still don't understand, I said, don't invest. Invest in what you understand. Don't say because somebody else is telling me I am doing that. So most of the time, simplify, understand, you have the, you can say miracle or the best thing in your life is that Google. Try to Google it out. Passive income is a very, very important part, as we say, that alternative income or the incomes where the money makes its own. Manage the money. So most of the time, I have another customers. He has been a CXO of a very good PR company, top three company in India, and earning like anything. And he, whenever I spoke 4 years back, and he said, "No, Rachna, I don't believe it in tomorrow. Let us have enjoyment as today only." So I used to say, "It's fair enough." So I also enjoy, but you do some percentage for future. Then he says, "No." And his means his life lavish was like a, he is a very hardcore music lover, and all his few bands people used to play live in like a US and Australia. He used to fly there and attend those bands live shows. Like that league he was in. And last he from March, so now it's almost 15 months he doesn't have a money, no salary. And it is so difficult for somebody, I can tell you, to change the lifestyles also. When you are not able to change the lifestyles, there is no income coming. Only wife was saving little bit money with us. She took all the money. She blessed me. She said, "Because of you, I am able to survive 1 year." 2-3 months back, she called me, "Rachna, I don't know. We are not able to even pay the EMI. You tell me what to do." So these are the story. We always try to say, learn from somebody. Don't reinvent the wheel when wheel is already invented. So it is okay. We learn from somebody and we better don't do the same thing because we don't know about future. And that's what today's session we are trying to focus on. Think how you can become a financially free and what are the different ways. So in your mind, you are sure shot you are taken care of. So to make sure to have a financial freedom, we have to make sure first level is to be have financial planning. So most of us, we plan, but we don't execute. So this is what we have done it for our office around a year back, that because we do it for everybody. So we need to make sure that we do it for our employees also. So we told everybody, please make sure that all our analysts to make sure these people are having the financial planning. So one of the salesperson I was talking, "Is it your financial planning is done? The reports are done?" And he says, "Yes, ma'am, everything is done. Only one thing is not done." I said, "What is not done?" He said, "No, I didn't execute." So it is the same thing. Then I asked him, "If you don't execute, how you can expect your customer to execute?" But the thing is, most of us, we will keep planning. But planning is a good, but if I don't execute, it has no value. So whenever we plan, I always tell, if you're not able to achieve 100%, at least start with 5% or 10%. You will achieve those part of it. So please tell me if you are able to hear it.
You work very hard because you want very best things for you and your family. So begin setting up smart goals based on what you want. Making sure they are specific with clear details, measurable with exact amount, attainable but challenging enough, realistic with necessary skills and knowledge. And it should be time-bound so that you start taking action without any delay. Next, you need to know where you stand financially. List down what and how much assets you own. Also list down how much liabilities you have. The difference between these two is your real net worth. It will give you an idea about how far you are from your goals. Third pillar is to know how much you need to save. Normally, people save whatever is left after spending from their income. But the right way of saving is to set aside at least 30% of your income based on your financial goals from your income. And then use what is left for your expenses. And finally, you need to create a budget for your finances. Budget helps you to save more. Also ensure that the payment of personal debt should not exceed 25% of your income at any level. Call us now to build strong.
what are the strong pillars and we should plan for it. Most of the time, whenever I have met any of my customers, the prospects and the leads, they say, why Rachna, you didn't meet me. I have lost already so many days or so many years. And I keep telling that there is nothing called loss. The day you have been aware, you start from that day. That itself is a good day. So same things I was talking about in our financial planning, or you can say first part of the planning and the highest part of a financial freedom is to take care of a risk management. Risk management is the one thing, if I have taken care properly, my freedom of thought, freedom of decision, I can say is exponential. And I'll give you an example of ours itself. We were on 15th anniversary, me and Anil was going abroad first time alone without kids. Middle of the year, I asked him that if something happens to both of us, what will happen? And then that is the time when I came back, I wrote the will also. And that's the time, one thing was very clear in my mind that even something happened, the kids' educations are taken care of because we have made that enough corpus to, they will not face an issue on this. So I am trying to say when we have a separate goals and the money is linked to that, and you know that this will take care of them, you don't find something is, of course, in the overall level, I was not sure how the company will work, how the kids will work and other things. And I came and I wrote the will. That's a different question. But I am trying to say, make sure your risks are taken care of, so you will never have a problem that even if I die tomorrow, what will happen? And this is the what I learned from my mentor 4 or 5 years back, that when I first time I started gone for mentor 4 or 5 years back. And that time that person says, what is your major fear kind of it? So I said, I have come from IT, and from IT 11-12% attrition itself is the higher. And in a financial services, the attrition is around 30%. So for me, it was like a guilt trip. If somebody quits, I used to cry in the tears. And Anil, who's the husband and CEO, he used to tell me they're just going, so don't worry and all. But I used to feel very scared if they leave, what will happen? Then I have to hire again, I have to teach again, and I have to do this. And that constant things used to make me even work their work also. I will work and I will slog, but I will not tell anybody. So this mentor told me, I never understand why you are getting so scared, so worked up, and you are doing so much and all. She asked me, Rachna, if you died today, what will happen to Right Horizons? And I said, nothing. Maybe it will take a few months. Half customer may stay, half may go. They will change the signatory. Nothing much. After 2-3 months, they'll be okay. Then she said, when the owners dies, only in 2-3 months, everything will become all right. When an employee die or employee leave, what's the big deal? So why you are worrying? And that changed my mind itself of a freedom. And that's where I always think that freedom comes in your mind, how we start thinking about. Similarly, if I knew that I have all the goals and from that goal, my present value of the money is there, or I have taken a good term cover for all goals of kids' education and the retirement for my spouse if something happens to me, and if I have the any of the loans to make sure that I have taken, which I'm just giving you some number, like a 2 crores or 3 crores. And if I have a 3 crores of term cover, which is life cover, because I'm the only earning member, makes sense. Or I have a 3 crore of my assets, which will back up my all the goals. You will always have in your mind that I am financially free for making sure my full family is taken care of. So in risk management, 3 things are very important. It's a life risk, health, and your assets. So how to manage those? This is very important part. This part will give you the freedom of thoughts, flexibility, and decision paths. These things you should always write. So most of the people, whoever I have met, even they are in 30s or 40s and 50s, very rarely, of course, COVID has changed few of the people's thought, but this is no, I have a corporate cover. I have a corporate term cover. I don't have an individual ones. So most of the corporate, sometimes they don't extend. And by the time when we exit from any of the corporate, we will be in late 40s or early 50s. then premiums are also very, very high, and sometimes we don't get those covers. So it is always good to have an alternative, a smaller cover if you want, because you are not going to use it. So then you can top up a little later. So that's a one of the part of the tip I can give you. Make sure that take care of a risk management. Very, very good. Risk is you are just managing and outsourcing your risk to somebody else. So you can't expect money back. So it is like your car insurance. So car insurance, what we do? If nothing happens, then money is gone. So I keep telling people, car is just a monetary value of maybe 5 lakhs, 10 lakhs car. We spend 5-7K of premium for my car. I use a smaller car. And Anil's is, I think, so Creta, which is 20 lakhs car. And we pay around 37 or 47K of car insurance. So for a 20 lakhs car, which we can buy if something happens to the car, we are paying 37,000 rupees every year. But we are priceless. Are we paying 37,000 rupees? We are not even giving ourselves as a priceless, as important. So that's the one part of it. Please do take care and make sure whatever is that amount of car insurance, you will get much, much more value. So term covers are very, very reasonable, and you will be able to make sure your financial freedom comes very fast. Contingency plans are very important. I have at least seen met a lot of people have learned quite a lot. A lot of people started saving quite a lot, but sometimes they are always in a positive. It's nice to be always positive that nothing will happen to my job. But sometimes I was reading, last week in the trending news that 3 lakhs people are going to go off because of artificial intelligence. So I really don't know, but that's another topic by itself, not a financial thing. How we are not sure what I'm earning today, I may earning tomorrow or not. I don't know, I'll be sustaining the same job because of some AI may come. So make sure that you are ready for tomorrow and you are have taking care of your contingency plans. Goal-based, of course, I will take it in the next. Of course, there are major 3 goals people are being taking care. This trend is changing, which I will tell in the future. The trends are a lot of differences coming of our thought versus not. Today, morning walk itself was having the thing. Most of the time, these are the need-based or goal-based approach. Not necessary everybody goes in the same timelines and the need, but generically, people have a wealth creation, management, and preservation. People talk about gadgets nowadays, it's also very high. So making a house, vehicle, if you get married, most of the people become a serious investor only after marriage because they felt it that this is the good point where we should seriously invest for our family. Then if they have a kids education, this is the time which I wanted to tell trips and vacation. Most of the time before, I'm talking about 3 to 5 years back, on an average, we make maybe 100 plus financial plan in a year. 99%, I can tell you, the trips and vacation was a last priority. If I have a money, I will then go for a trip and vacation. But last 3 and 5 years, that priority has gone to second. So this is first maybe a retirement, second is a trips and vacation, and third goes to the education. And I was very surprised. I said, why it is like that? So their thought is, Rachna, when we are old, we may not able to go and have the vacation or walking or trekking or whatever it is. So it makes sure that we do it. And for the vacation and trips, there is nothing called loan. At least for an education, we can take a loan. So most of the time, on an average, I'm telling you, an AFP, 10 to 20 lakhs in a year going to the vacation has become a trend, I think so. Which I've never thought of that people will put that much of money on a yearly basis. Of course, those money has come as an investment last 1.5 years because they have not gone, but they always plan for it. So that's another trend I have seen, which people have been trying to do it, which was not there 5 years back. The second trend is that a lot of people nowadays, even in financial planning, even the kids are 3 years old or 5 years old, they assume that their kids will go undergrad abroad. Undergrad means for us is like a degree, which is after 12th standard, which is approximately minimum you can think of 1.5 to 2 crores as on today value. which was not there. Most of the time, previously, people used to go for a master's. That is, the second trend has changed quite a lot in the recent past. So what are the different goals we have? So we have a vacation abroad, car, retirement, buying house, flat, farms. Nowadays, doing the organic farming is also one of the things people have been changing quite a lot. Child's marriage and child's education. But child's marriage nowadays has become a very low priority. If 100 FP I'm doing, only 5 or 10 we'll take as a child education as a goal. They said they will manage it. We should give a good education. That's the way it has been doing. So most of the time, if you see that these are the goals we should plan and make sure each of the asset class is linked to that. If we have linked each of our investment to these goals, very, very rarely I can tell you we will redeem the money. If we have not mapped the goal, we will always try to redeem. So last Saturday, I had another call of one of the reference customer, and he has come from US after 8-10 years. So he he's been using a wealth manager in US. So he came and he explained that I wanted to do wealth management. So I asked, please tell me what exactly I can help you. So most of the time I try to understand their family, their background and other things, and what best suits them, I try to do. So he says, no, I'm very clear. I want a wealth creation only and with the highest risk. I said, that's perfectly fine. That's the best thing. You have a very good clarity in your mind. So I'm assuming if I'm taking a wealth creation with the highest risk, it means that you have taken care of your risk management, your goal mapping and everything else. So you are come to the next league of wealth creation. Then he's telling me, actually, I've not done anything. I don't have a health cover. I don't have a term cover. I don't have a mapping to the kids' education. I don't know it is achievable or not. So sometimes what we always try to say a person, it is good to have a wealth creation as a part of our financial planning. But first level is we try to say, make sure, as I was talking in this part of it behind, that take care of your risk management, contingency, and then goal base. So the sequence goes that only. So you should have a good health cover, good term cover, make sure of good emergency planning, minimum 10 to 15 lakhs or 6 months of your household income, and then go back to the goal based planning. So that's the way we should go. And then you can think of how I can create the wealth part of it. So this steps to have a financial freedom, I believe, and not only experience, but I have seen. So most of the time when I ask somebody, why don't you invest? The common answer I get it, Rashna, I don't have money. So this answer is a very common thing. And my belief is whatever I have learned here or when I was working previously, actually money doesn't make people wealthy, because I have seen a people who is earning even 4 to 5 crore a year has not a good portfolio. The person who is having 10 to 20 lakhs also have a very good portfolio. And this is the one thing, even my parents itself, I can say that they're having a better portfolio than even we are earning 10 times more than them. So most of the time, actually, it is not the money. It is our own behavior patterns makes it financially free. What are our thoughts? What is our attitude? What is the behavior on our money creation and all? So first is we need to set the goals. If I am not having a goal, we will never achieve those goals. So whenever I go to the any corporate and do the training, I always say, you don't need to go to any far off, even to me or anybody, if you want to have a good financial planner. The best person, our financial planner, was our parents or mainly our mothers. Because if you go back, they were very clear, even they were having a very less earning. But most of the time, the clarity was so good that we will get the good or new dresses only on our birthday or the any other festival. We will have for any of the fees or going out, that money was set aside. So their goals was very clear, and we never faced, even though the salaries and the income was so low. Why? Because they're doing the things on a disciplined manner was very, very good. They were very, of course, for me, for people who are new, I'm a person who is ex-army person's daughter, so have a much more come as a part and parcel of discipline. So how to take a decisions? Mostly, as Radha was telling, how to take a decision, still till date, to make a decision, I always believe that you write it across the pros and cons and try to find either through web or your near one, dear ones, to find what may be their opinion, because it is a third party, separate opinions. Give respect to everybody's opinion. So most of the time, what happens if somebody is giving a decision and opinions which is against us, we normally don't like those person. But take a separate opinion because they have a different view. Everybody is right in their own perspective. So they have a different view. Try to judge the pros and cons part of it and take the decision. But always execute what you feel comfortable. It's not that ki my brother feel comfortable or sister or my dad has told, that's why I'm doing. The decision should be taken by you, not by others, because we own the part of it. Today's itself in one of our group, it was coming that how the Google CEO Sundar Pichai's mentor has been asking only one question to him every time, that what make you last week to go away from the ties? And that's what the question came is to me also when I was just before this session. How you can have a many people giving a decisions or new things being a CEO of Google itself, but your each action, you owns it, because you have to be happy and you should be consciously right that I have done what is right as per you, not from others. So you cannot blame others. Third is patience. I believe, and this is the way we always try to tell people, you can think of money is the same as your normal tree. Today we were walking and somebody told me, of course they have sent it some mangoes, and I said, it's so nice, uncle, mango you have sent it. He said, yeah, in our land there are 4 or 5 trees has come. So I said, wow, you. So he says, no, the tree have taken almost 10 years and afterwards it started fruit. So that remind me today that yes, the money also takes the same thing. When you put a seed as a investment, you how you put a water and manure and sunlight, then it grows, and after 10-15 years it started giving you flowers and fruits. Similarly, your power of compounding and things works the same way. Manage risk. This is the most important part. Most of us will always say that yes, I can manage the risk, and I am sure you take the high risk, Krishna. So there are two kind of people. They will say you take the high risk, and when there even the 5% of the principal also goes, they will say, okay, my God, how it's possible? Or they will say, you give me the low risk and but give the returns of 10-12% returns. So you should have very clear the concept clear on what is a risk management, which I will take it in a next few slides. So as I told you, this is the survey done again by the Edelweiss. Failing to plan is planning to fail is most of the time is 87%. So this is the four major behavior why somebody can create a wealth, do financial planning and have a financial freedom. This is the very best thing. One of the, as I told you, all of you must be knowing, the two friends who started the cricket career together, they were equally talented. Maybe one were, A was bit better than the B, but B went on playing for 24 years. A just disappeared and he failed. And success achieved early in his year. So do you, anybody can guess who is A and B? Yeah, so I think so most of the people have given the right answer. So this is the Kapil Dev's note for both of them. Discipline was a key differentiator between Sachin and Vinod. So this is not only in the sports, even in the, you can say, wealth creation, even our day-to-day office work or in our home. If you have a discipline, it works wonders. And discipline is one of the keys. I always believe that you don't have to, because it has to come within. You can't enforce more daily basis. If I keep asking our kids, you do this, they said, okay, mama, you are giving so much of gyan, you leave it. So it has to come from their own. And that is the one thing which I always tell a person, that please have a good discipline. This is the Warren Buffet. I can say everybody is aware of. This is the father of all wealth creation. Is talking about successful investing takes time, discipline, and patience. No matter how great the talent and effort, something just take time. You can't produce a baby in 1 month by getting 9 women pregnant. So this line always reminds me of my ex-boss. He, whenever we used to have a T&M proposal, no, he used to say that, Rashna, make sure that you can't put 9 people working and then do the delivery in 1 month, because it takes its own sweet time. So we have to make sure that discipline, we should continue. It can be health, it can be investment, and it can be sports. It works wonder. So I'm sure all of you who have been a part of a sports or something, even if the marathon runner or something, they will start having a discipline. Go slow by slow, then they start walking, then they start jogging, and then they started doing and taking care on the major part. So first part of a financial freedom, apart from all the concept level, is behavior level, is first we should be having a discipline. And when we have discipline, I can tell you, even till 2019, the people who were doing NSIPs, they used to come and tell me, in 3 years also, it is so negative, Rachna. And I used to say that, don't worry, SIPs are only always for the long term, and you don't know when these will just switch. And suddenly they started, I'm saying the 3 years negative plus now 2 years positive, they started giving around almost like a 18, 20, 22% returns. And they said, can I now invest more? I said, no, it is a better of averaging. So that will take care. So only time is for, I keep telling people, whenever the market is low, actually we get the highest customer, because that's the only time they think that we need an advisor. Otherwise, when the market is high, they themselves as a fund manager. Because we are just trying to make people aware, trying to say what is right. And third thing is, we are making them detach their emotion with their investments. Because most of the time, if you see the fear and greed major issues, are because the emotion get attached. So that is the one thing which we have to try to say, that when the market is low, so most of our customers who are old, whenever the market fall, they will call us, Rashna, I have additional this much money, can you do it? Because they have aware, they have seen that one down and up. But the people who are new, they are not sure, those fear comes across. So market is just like a history repeat itself, but it is emotion get attached, it is an issue. So have a good discipline. Do a good investments, goal-based investment. Don't attach emotions to that part of it. Good diversification, it will give a good returns.
If you want to go around the earth and start with 100 meters on the first day and double the distance every day, how long do you think it will take? 1 year? 10 years? Let's find out. Within 19 days, you would have covered 39,321 kilometers, while the equatorial circumference of Earth is about 40,075 kilometers. You would have traveled around the world in less than 20 days. But what if you stop after 10 days? You would have hardly covered a little less than 77 kilometers. This is the power of compounding. Power of compounding can help you to create a great wealth as well. How to leverage the power of compounding for maximum benefit? Start early at the age of 35. By the age of 60, both would have invested 21 lakh rupees. Assuming a return of 12%, Nisha will accumulate 2.75 crore rupees. While Nilesh will get only 1.19 crore rupees, which is 59% lesser than Nisha's wealth. This is why starting early is important. To create a wealth, start an SIP in Equity Mutual Fund, and remember.
So that just talks about how the power of compounding works, and again, the more important core part is how to set the goals. So whenever we are trying to set the goals for any of our financial goals, we should have a short term, mid term, and long term. So when we speak with so many of our youngsters and customers, sometimes for them short term is very short. But in our term, short term is below 3 years, 3 to 8 years and 8 years and above. The reason I'm saying it because the type of investment what we get, otherwise because what will happen, any of the goals which is coming in 2 years, we don't know market how it's going to do. So we will not take a risk on the market. So most of the time, if somebody is coming and this is Dashna, even one or two people, some random numbers they'll give like, yeah, I have 100 share, 200 share kind of it. Why don't you invest and give me good return? And I always say that, please have a tea and you can go somewhere who's ready to give you the good returns, because we never take any customer for a short term. We have to realize it. We may give a good return, we may not, because the market is not necessary in 1 year will give the good returns. Nobody is God here. So we normally try to say, if somebody is coming to us, it should stay with 5 years and above, because you are able to take care of one side of the market upside. So short term, always try to say not to take a market linked any of the investments. Midterm, we always say balance plus taking care of equity, and long is always equity driven. Goal settings with a personal, it's a very, very important part of it. Don't try. So most of the time it happens that when we get our money, we don't realize it. Okay, smallest thing I have seen people, Prashna, I have small amount money required. Can I redeem it or can I do it? So don't try to have a spending which is already been mapped to your goal. Try to, if you have redeemed it or redeem and withdraw it, you can reinvest it. That is a better part of it. Plan it, budget it. Very important. That is the way, if I do it, I'm sure our kids also will try to learn the same way. If we are able to go as per our budget, we will never go out of the things. Patience is very, very important, which says that patience is not the ability to wait, but how you act while waiting is very, very important, and allow your investment to compound. So this is an all-time favorite of my Warren Buffett's quotation is, someone is sitting in the shade today because someone planted a tree long time ago. That we have to always remember. So this I have already spoken about. So this is another one, which is the last one. I'll just put it across.
Chinese bamboo is the world's tallest grass, which goes up to as high as 80 to 90 feet in a little over 5 years. When you sow the seed and start watering and nurturing it daily, you don't see it growing for 5 years. It would be frustrating, isn't it? But wait, miracle happens after 5 years. It grows from 0 to 80 feet in less than 90 days. Similarly, growing wealth through SIP also requires a lot of patience. Had you started an SIP of rupees 10,000 in September 2010 in large cap fund, the value of your total investment of 3.6 lakh rupees would have been 3.57 lakh rupees after 3 years. Had you stopped an SIP, this temporary loss would have been permanent loss. But had you continued an SIP at the end of the fourth year, your value of total investment of 4.8 lakh rupees would have been 6.95 lakh rupees. And if your SIP still continues till March 2019, the value of total investment of rupees 10.3 lakhs would have been 17.38 lakh rupees. Remember, correction is temporary, growth is permanent. So continue your SIP for long term to create wealth.
Managing risk is a very, very important part. Try to understand how you think you can manage risk. So easiest way, this question I ask people is, how much money you think if goes down is not impacting your lifestyle? That much you should able to take the risk. And if that is gone, you just ignore it, it will come back. Because it's, as he says, it's a logical loss. It's not at a permanent loss. So take away from those fours are, set your goals, take the smart decision, have patience, and manage the risk. I'll come to this calculator if I have a time. Otherwise, I'll be part of, I'll send it across this calculator. This part, I want all of you to take a small test yourself to see that which part of the things you are being taking. Hello? Okay. I mean, this is the part of, I can say, the digital glitch coming across. Even though today being a weekend, they were saying the curfew. I thought I'll come to the office, so we will not have this network issues, but sorry again. I was trying to tell here is how to make sure which stage we are in. And whenever we are, if you think you are unstable, you are alternative, go to the next step, another one. So that's the way we have to take a one small step by step to make sure that we are financially have our independence and the freedom. So survival is, as I was trying to say, there is no saving and heavy debts. So you, most of the people may not be in this. Mostly people are in taking care of alternatives. So stability is where you're repaying the loans, bills, taking, eroding the monthly saving, because as on today, you don't have anything else. Then you're just putting an SB account or an FD where you're not even taking care of the inflation. Alternatives is additional loan payments, say for longer term. More can be done, but you are not taking the maximum benefit. So most of the time people are in the alternatives. We have to move to the step one by one and make sure that we are independent. Repaying all debt, so we have to make sure how we reduce our debt. We started doing an adequate retirement planning. Most of the retirement planning, when I have heard, seen people coming to me, they say, okay, Rashna, I require 50,000 from now, and they must have started taking some plans or the planning that they will get 50,000 rupees after 10 years for 99 years or whatever. So I keep saying that whenever you are doing a retirement planning, you need to take care of inflation also. We may not be working, but inflation continues working. So retirement planning, one of the things when you're doing for yourself, make sure that take care of inflation till you're starting, and from that time when the payout start till your whatever you are taking as a, I can say 85 years or 95 years, whatever the longevity. Make sure that you have taken care of all the needs. You are on track, doing perfectly fine. And last but not the least, you are doing independent and you are giving back to the charity also. So this stage will give you yourself which you stage you are in and how to do it. This is the slide. I will try to spend maybe last 2-3 minutes and I'll take up over queries. How I was trying to tell that time, what are the different investment options people have or what are the risks involved? So whenever there is any investments, you have to understand they are under two different, sector kind of it or a blob kind of it. One is fixed return and one is non-fixed. Like people always say, it's like a guaranteed return, you can say, or it is you are aware of. So what is a fixed returns? So the difference between fixed and non-fixed is whenever there is something is fixed, in the time of purchase only you will know. Like if, for example, if you go to now in a bank and you say, I want an FD for 1 year, or they will say 366 days, 1 year, 1 year, or 1+ day or whatever. So if you have that, they will say, okay, the rate is 5.5. So you are aware that my returns will give me 5.5. It can be a NSE or GPO, MIS, PF, PPF kind of it. So when you are aware of the fixed returns are very, very low, I can say risk. They do have a risk. It's not that they don't have a risk. Like so many banks you must have seen, they have been NPA. They have merged because of PSUs. Some of the cooperative banks is already an NPA also. They were not able to give even fixed deposits and all. So most of the time they do have it. Like even if you have a fixed deposit and a bank become NPA, by now new rule, which is last year only, they said they will get a 5 lakhs. Before it was just a 1 lakh rupees, even if you have 50 crore or 5 lakhs. So most of the time they do have it, but the risk level is very low in the fixed returns. But fixed returns most of the time, other than a PF and PPF, is not even crossing your inflation. Most, why you have to understand? how fixed returns are given? Fixed returns are given most of the time with the government bonds. And the government bonds yield is lesser than the any of the inflation. You will be surprised to know the yield of government tax-free bond is as of today is 4.6 and 4.8. So, and normal bonds are giving approximately 7%. If you do taxation, it will come to the same tax-free bonds. So these are good when you are not on a higher tax bracket. You are taking care, you have enough, so you don't want to take risk. So most of these, you should make sure 100 minus your age, you should take care whatever is the equity and the rest debt. But if you have to beat inflation, if you have to create the wealth, you have to go to the non-investment side. So if you can imagine two names in your mind whom you think that person have the more money, you will 100% will realize that person has got money not because of keeping in FD or SB account, must have either have his own company's equity shares or he is having a equity shares of other company and holding for long. So that's the only place where people have made money. So it's not that non-fixed has not got money. They have got the money. Most of the time, all the rich people will be in that 99.9% will be in that side only. But why they have got money, that's very, very important, because they're holding the stocks for long. They are not the trading or they're doing the daily trade. So equity is where we are talking about shares, stocks and all. You can buy through mutual fund, direct stocks. You can have different ETFs nowadays, or you can PMS, AIF, whatever. AIF is a new trend which has come now. How to invest in a non-listed stocks or the companies which is budding. Those are the AIF, which is a little higher side, non-listed ones. I'm still talking about the listed side. Gold is again another thing where when you buy the gold is not telling you what is the returns you will get, because again, when you sell, that time you realize that how much returns you have got. So gold is nowadays physical form, and you have a mutual funds also of a gold and ETFs also there. Commodities, real estate and ULIP. These are the non-fixed returns. Most of the time, I always say make sure the good you have a 100 minus 8, or maybe if you want little more higher risk, but make sure at least 20 to 25% you have it in a fixed returns or the low risk side, and 70 to 75% in a, I can say, wealth side. It can be equities or real estate, ULIPs kind of it. So I am happy to take any questions from all of you. Main 9 points drive across, which I have told spoken on till now. Make sure you have a goals, short, medium, and long term. Make sure quantify them and map your investment. Take care of your risk. Make sure minimum 20 to 25% you do it. I have been doing from the day one till date, and I can say you it's a wonderfully very good compounding return comes. I have never missed 1 month also till date. Last 26 years. Good investment avenues. Think about post-tax, post-inflation part of it. Balance the risk and returns. Do equity for a long term through SIP and STP. Take a regular check minimum at least twice. That's all from my side. I'll be happy to take questions. I wrote it already that we are a part of Right Horizons and they are the wealth advisory firms. If you want in the future any help, we'll be happy to do it.
Hi, madam.
Yes.
My name is Jaypal from Hyderabad.
Hi.
Madam, what is your view on this NPS for tax saving? Is it good?
Very good. So you should always make sure that NPS, if it is your company is also linked, so you can take a 10% of your basic also as a part of an NPS. It will give you the best part of this is when you take your returns, it may be a taxable, but the best part is you are getting a tax benefit if you are in 30% bracket on the same year also. So please do take care NPS if you have.
Thank you, madam. I have one more question. Like regarding health insurance, I have a corporate health insurance, but I'm planning to take outside health insurance also. Do you want me to take this critical illness also? What your view?
Nowadays, it's a very cheap when you do add-on. So it is better you can take it. But even if you have not taken, it is good enough. So you take a small part of it as in health insurance. So if you're not claiming, you get a no claim bonus anyway, because you may be using a corporate health cover.
Thank you very much, ma'am.
Yeah.
Hello.
Yes.
Myself Radha, ma'am.
Yes, hi, Radha.
Hi, ma'am. What about the investment in real estate? It is for 5 years they are giving that. Right? After that, 5 years we'll be getting the apartment or home or that.
See, which part of the place you stay in India?
Bangalore, I am staying in Bangalore. Okay.
So then, because I'm also from Bangalore, so I'll just give it because I don't know about others much. Most of the time, if you are looking for a real estate for self-occupied, I feel that's the best time to take because you have a power of negotiation now. Okay? Because most of the places in Bangalore where buyers are less and selling apartments are too many and they have to repay quite a lot of their loans and other things. So you should buy. But if you are looking for an alternative income through a real estate or real estate from the longer term, I will say we should not do it. So I'll give you a few examples now. The person now, if you have taken an apartment, because I have a few customers who are seen both the side, the apartment is around 50, 60 lakhs, but the rent comes only 20, 22K. Okay. So most of the time, if I see the rental and then too, they're paying through EMI also. So you have an EMI. Next is your yield for the rent is not crossing more than 3%. So why to take things, and especially in COVID time, where people, even the commercial rents are not going. Before, commercial rent used to be 6 to 7%. If you see all the malls, if you see, I think so, there's a article came that all the mall owner has lost like a 3,000 crores and other things like that. So, and there is a trend on a GDP. So if you see globally, whenever, whichever country has crossed 3 trillion GDP, which is we are almost there, people go from fixed asset to the liquid assets, and that's a trend going on. So most of our customers start selling. They said, Dashna, my kids are going abroad and studying and they're settling down. They may not come and try to liquidate. Please liquidate and do it across. So there are a lot of trends are also changing. Okay. And previously we used to say rental will take care of our retirement, but nowadays people have noticed it is not even doing that part of it. So taking through a loan second real estate may not be the good time now.
Okay. And another question, ma'am. What about the liquid funds? I have saw the ad in the phone pay. Liquid funds, you invest in better. I want clarity about the liquid funds.
Most of the time, I say if you liquid funds are some things which you want a money within a 1 year, we always try to say them we should have it in a liquid funds. But if you all are, or I don't know about you are not in 30% tax bracket, I feel you can do it in a FD or so you will have a much more comfort zone. So I always believe you do what is in comfort zone, but liquid assets are good to park the money if you wanted anything requirement below 1 year. Because you have a flexibility. Okay. If you have taken for example, 3 months FD and you required a money in 2 months, 28 days, for example, they will reduce the 0.5% or 0.25% of the FD, whatever for 3 months, it's not even 4%. And then they reduce it. But even a liquid money, you can redeem any time and the returns are taken care of. So it's a better than FD, flexible, but it's you have to see what is your comfort zone.
Okay. Thank you. Now I will be meeting in the Arkere. You are staying, na? I saw the address.
Yes.
Arkere. Okay. I will be meeting you, ma'am. Thank you.
Ma'am, there is one question from our attendee named Ankilesh. What amount of health cover should be enough?
Previously, I used to tell always 10 to 15 lakhs is good enough. But if you combined your corporate plus that, please do it. I have changed last 5-6 years back because one of my customers says you are lucky you didn't find any of your people in a critical illness, otherwise it goes. Personally, I have taken a 50 lakhs because what I've realized is if I take for 25 and 50, the amount for the premium was very marginal and then it gives a better. But on an official note, I always feel 15 to 20 lakhs is a good enough. So if you have a corporate of 5 to 7 lakhs, take a 10 lakhs additional.
One more question, ma'am. Investing in NPS versus equity, which is better?
both of them have a different goals mapping. Both of them have a different thoughts, because NPS is done for two reasons. One is to do a tax saving now immediately, because there is no other way apart from ATC and ATE and other things to do it if you are in old regime, and it is taken care of for retirement. So that's the way. And NPS by default, it is like a ULIP, which can go maximum only 70% on equity. It cannot go above that. So we have to realize, if you are looking for a retirement and tax benefit, NPS is better. But if you are taking for a wealth creation, you have to go for the equity driven.
One more question, ma'am, from Madhusudan. Assuming unrealistic equity returns, his doubt is that it is quite easy to make a retirement calculation look rosy. Even today, we can easily find mutual fund distributors and advisors making projections with 12% or 14% returns. But in reality, it's not right, because we always project only best times returns at peak.
So I'll give you an example on my own personal basis, forget it anybody else. I have been started investing from 94, and from 94 I have been doing, that time ELSS was only 20%, 20,000 in other things, and I have been doing NSIPs and other things. So whenever you take it as a market from 1970 till date, if the large cap index itself has given 14% of the compounding returns. So that's the first point. It's a data point level. So who, and I have been doing an investing of SIP more than 22 or 23 years plus, maybe more than that. And I have been getting 18% returns. Okay. I can share my, even my portfolio also. But the question here is, I have never redeemed. I've never stopped. Why? And that's what I keep telling people is, you are investing to link to my kids' education and for my retirement. My kids' education is the goal has not come, neither my retirement. So my SIPs are continuing. Why people are been having that SIPs are not giving or something is not giving? Because they take a very random decision on the negativity. I keep telling, you are looking your portfolio in your maybe reports in laptop or something, and you're taking decision. Is it you have ever thought of the your wife's and yours having so much of gold is so negative if I do XIRR? If you have a real estate, can you see that how much XIRR is negative? 2013 till now, that real estate is not even giving XIRR 2.5%. Most of us, we just see what we can feel, and we fine-tune our mind that way. But it is not anybody's telling. In the assumption, you should see how that fund is doing for 10 years, because you are looking your debt investment for your goal. So you take, forget it, you don't have to listen to any of the advisors. You listen to the data points, do a data analysis, and do it across. You take any 10 years, the bull market, bear markets, flat market, you will get 10 to 12% returns.
Ma'am, one more question. What asset allocation would you have for a goal which is 5 years from now? Moderate risk taker.
So if it is a moderate risk taker, normally 70% goes to the equity and 30% goes to the debt.
How do you see real estate sector investment in next 3 to 5 years?
Real estate sectors will pick up soon, because now home loans are lowest level, or I can say all time low. As of today, some of them are 6.6 to 6.9. So people who are been renting, they will start thinking, why don't I start doing it? And real estate is a lagger of the equity also, so should come up within 3 years. So that's why I said it is good. You have a negotiation powers now if you wanted to buy for a self and other things.
Ma'am, one more question. If I want to take 1 crore term insurance, it should be 50 lakhs plus 50 lakhs from two insurance companies, or 1 crore from one insurance company? Which one is better?
I have taken a 3 CR. I have taken from one company. It doesn't matter, because whenever you grow across the sum limit, they also have a reinsurance, and they will check it across where you are. So it's not that if I'm doing two, so they are fooling somebody, or medical doesn't come. So it comes the same way. But people have the thinking that, Rachna, it is like I'm de-risking and other things. So it's again a mindset. the reinsurer is the same for everybody and RTAs are the same. So I will recommend normally taking it's easier and simpler to have a one term cover than two term cover. But if you feel a comfort in your mind that I'm taking a two different companies and I may have a better service, it's also true.
Okay, this is the last question asked by Radha. Investment in agriculture.
I don't know much about it because I have not done it that area. I'll take last two, Nidhi.
Yes, ma'am. One more question. Wanted to know what is the deductible converting in zero after 5 years in SubTopUp plan? I'm not aware of that.
I'm also not aware of. So, Harsh, can you just let me know? If you can write the mail, I'll write the mail ID.
SubTopUp plan. I just wanted to know what is the deductible converting to zero after 5 years in SubTopUp plans.
I'm not sure of, I'm sorry.
Okay.
I'll get back to you.
Okay, thank you.
Arjun, gold bond, is it good?
It is good. Again, it depends on if you're looking on a debt side. 5% of the portfolio, we always say you can keep it in a gold because gold is a contrarian as a cushion to the equity and all. But we should not go more than 5% in our overall portfolio on the gold because gold also have never crossed in 30 years perspective as 7% on XIRR. And 7% also has given, if you see only dollar, it is 4.5 or 4 because of the currency conversion. So I will always say is more than 5% on a portfolio, you should not go for gold. Otherwise, you can take it a gold as a till your 5% of the portfolio. That's what we do also.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am, we are done. Okay, there's one more question which came. How is investing in small case?
Small case is a platform and that takes, it's like a small, all the funds you can choose with the saying that this is a large cap or medium risk or a risk. And then small case is a platform. Like you can say Ola, Uber and all the stuff is the platform and then you're doing a renting. Similarly, small case is a platform. People are used to make their portfolios as a low risk, medium risk and other things like that. So I'll just take it last one. Shruti, I started with CSIP in Mirae Asset Emerging. Now it's going. It's a very good fund. Please continue. So thanks a lot for your wonderful time. And I am assuming you have understood and you will be achieving a financial freedom soon. And have a wonderful weekend and enjoy and spread happiness. Thanks a lot.